As we go out to serve as workers in the world, on this Labor Day in particular, we remember the labor of all those who went before us, and I call forward from Rabbi Chicago, Jim Longino.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
My name is Jim Longino, and I just want to make a little sidebar message. I want you to know that people like myself and many others stand together in solidarity with all of the people here at this church who have experienced that terrible issue that happened with science in front of your church. So I just want to give you my heartfelt concern and thank you again for letting me be here today and understand that we all feel that love is the answer. And I want to thank Reverend Sally and the congregation for having me here. Again, my name is Jim Longino, and I am part of two indivisible groups in the western suburbs. Indivisible LaGrange, LaGrange Park, Indivisible Western Springs, and the LaGrange Working Families Committee in LaGrange. It is an honor to be here with you today. I am speaking as part of Arise Chicago's Labor in the Pulpit program, where speakers in over 115 services throughout Cook County are speaking on the connection between faith and the work and dignity of work. I come from a family of two brothers, and including myself. Both my sets of grandparents came from another country. My parents were born before the Depression, and my father, after World War II, was able, through a union position, to provide for our family while my mom stayed at home to raise us. Sadly, we don't see this type of arrangement as possible for anyone with a very affluent now, as everyone needs to have two incomes. And since the late 1970s, we've seen a complete decline in wages, union representation to protect workers, and of those jobs which provide a minimum of full-time positions with supportive wages for oneself, not to mention the family. This is why I felt compelled to speak about why, if you are working full-time, I feel you should be able to have wages that provide for a livable, independent life. All of our major faith traditions believe that each of us has been created in the image of God. A profound truth that is empowering and humbling. It is empowering because wherever we go, we carry the spark of the divine within us. This includes when we cross the threshold into our own workplaces. The divine goes with us. However, the inherent sacredness and dignity is often disregarded in the workplace. When God spoke to Moses at the burning bush, the instructions to Moses were to lead the people out of oppressive working conditions and into the land flowing with milk and honey. In this moment, God forever linked faith with work. Further, God signaled that the handful of people at the top are not to hoard the fruits of labor that were created by those at the bottom. Amen. To put it another way, in the words of Dr. King, we cannot create a society where we give luxuries to the few, but not the necessities to the many. Amen. But yet we see this happen every day. And I saw it happen throughout the western suburbs with the Cook County minimum wage and paid sick days ordinance. In fact, in spite of our efforts in LaGrange and reassurances, we were blindsided by a concerted effort of outside lobbyists and local business associations working to convince the board 4 days before the Cook County minimum wage efforts to take effect to go against 73% of us who voted for increasing wages and providing sick leave. These powerful interests took away and continue to take away the basic necessities of life from working people, such as paid sick days and a fair minimum wage, which, quite honestly, was not enough to live on anyway. But we are invited to change the narrative. We are invited by God to act interdependently to ensure that everyone has a seat at the table and is able to share in the abundance of God's creation. Instead of looking at the dysfunction at the state and national level, people looked locally to change local policies to benefit the most vulnerable among us. And that is why thousands of us in the suburbs of Cook County still rose up to demand fair pay and working conditions for all working people. And thanks to your great work here, you won those same rights for all workers in Oak Park, and I thank you for that. But we can't stop there. We have to grow into a powerful movement of faith-based activists to take on the most critical issues of our time, including still revisiting this wage and sick leave issue in those suburbs and throughout the state, which still voted to take away these rights from all workers. Around Chicago, an indivisible LaGrange, LaGrange Park, indivisible Western Springs, and the LaGrange Working Families Committee stand with people in the margins who are facing workplace exploitation.
Amen.
Did you know, wage workers, that over $1 million a day is stolen from low-wage workers in Cook County, many of whom are immigrants? Stealing wages is one of the reasons that 10 million full-time workers are still living below the poverty level. And the folks earning low wages are not teenagers looking for movie money. 89% of the people earning low wages are age 21 or older. People like us, trying to support themselves and their families. Delegates to the United Church of Christ General Synod 2017 voted in favor of a resolution advocating for economic justice and a $15 minimum wage. Said Reverend Marilyn Kendix, who was in attendance, our extravagant welcome to all God's people requires more of us than merely welcoming them to our sanctuaries on Sunday. It requires us to welcome everyone to share the blessings of God. We are empowered and humbled by the good news that we are all created in the image of God. We are here to make sure we understand our call to see that all people have the necessities to live. We are inviting worshipers into that humble space to listen for that still, small voice within us as we seek to answer what role each of us must play in creating a just economic system. Let us move forward from this place knowing that God calls us to act so that each person truly does have a seat at the table and can fully enjoy the abundance of God's creation together for love. I will be at the back of the church at the end of the service if anyone has questions or wants to become involved in our work for justice. And from our family at Arise Chicago, the local indivisible groups, and the LaGrange Working Families Committee, to yours, we wish you all a very happy Labor Day. Thank you very much.